Hello students, how are you all? Hope everyone is doing good and carefully following my lectures. So every topic is important, it is main point of view. So last video I gave introduction about electric current. So what is the meaning of electric current, how to use sine convention, what is difference between conventional current and what is actual current direction, and types of materials like insulators and conductors. All those introductions I give, but I didn't give a started electric current definition, but not given any idea about that. So let us walk that only. First of all, how to define electric current I. So already I told you, right? So current can be defined as rate of flow of charges. So rate of flow of charges means, so this is a conductor. So through this conductor, if you apply some potential difference, so these are the free electrons available in the conductor. So through this free electrons, if you apply some potential difference in this conductor, so potential difference, if you apply V, so all the electrons will come, then there will be, we are taking current direction, I current is flowing through the, actual electrons will come in this direction, but as I said, our convention is taking opposite direction to the direction, this is the current direction always from taking from positive terminal of the battery to negative terminal of the battery. So if you take like this, so suppose if Q charges is coming, so electric current can be defined as, this is basic definition, simply will tell us current definition, we define like this, current, electric current is equal to charge by time, means rate of flow of charges. So we can define like this, I is equal to, this is the basic, your 10th standard also can be doing like this itself only. So current can be defined as I is equal to Q by T, within overall basic first definition, or small amount of current will flow, we can define like this also, rate of flow of electric charges, rate of flow of electric charges through a given cross sectional area. Through a given cross section area, is called, your rate of flow means we are taking unit time only, called electric current. So we can write electric current as like this. Suppose in a small time, small charge can be flow dq by dt, we can write like this also. So small current can be defined in at an instantaneous time, we can define like this. This is a, you can type like also, q is can be written as number of electrons by time period also, we can write here itself, we can write q is equal to Q is equal to Ne, so Ne by time period T, in a time, unit time, how many number of charges flow, that much of current flowing through the body, we are telling, defining. So if you want, this is can be written in variable terms also. Suppose if constant current flow, it will be like this. If current is variable, you can take integration also. Suppose in small time, this is, you take it as the dA, means this is small current. Small current you take it as dA. So whole current if you want, you can do integration also. Suppose if you know small current, if you want to know dK, means charge also, you can write small charge, if you bring this side from this, what you can write, this is also formula, dQ by dT is the basic formula. We are writing I is equal dI, general I only. So suppose if you bring this I, if you know this d, don't take like this only. I is equal to dq by dt. Suppose if I is variable, if you want to calculate I is variable, and if you want to calculate to q, then you can take this dt this side. I dt can be written as dq, or if you take integration on both sides, integral I dt can be written as integral dq. So from this integral dq will be from 0 to q, or whatever the limits also you can apply. So if you apply the limits, then you will get total charge q is equal to integral I dt will become like this. So however, this is the charge formula by using current, but anyway current can be defined like this itself only. So current is equal to dq by dt only we are calling. So our current is rate of flow of charges, dq by dt. This is at instant. So whole charges will flow. Basic meaning current is equal to charge by time, total charge flow in a unit time, which is just like this. Charge flow in unit time. Charge flow in unit time we call it as electric current. So that we can be written as I is equal to q by t, or q is equal to ne by t also we can write, or in case of small current will flow, small charges will flow, then we can write I is equal to dq by dt or ne by dt. Or if you want to know calculate reverse order charges will flow, then we can take integration also like this process. But this is a basic useful formula. Many times I we generally written as I is equal to dq by dt. This is just like a speed, speed is equal to distance by time, or the total distance covered in a unit time. Same thing, I current is equal to charge by time, total charge flow in a unit time, total charge flow in a unit time we can call it as current only. So like this we can define electric current. So first of all, electric current is a scalar quantity. SI units, what is SI units of current? That is SI units ampere. Ampere is SI units, capital A we are using symbol. So this is one of the fundamental physical quantity. Electric current is a fundamental MLT, we are using that ampere is there. Ampere can be defined as a Q by T also, that what we did. And one more thing, it is a scalar quantity. Electric current, it is a scalar quantity. Electric current is a scalar quantity, does not depend on the direction. It always flow from positive charge to, but have direction, direction will be always, generally we are considering always flow, but we don't want to apply any vector rules, that's why it is a scalar. But will go always flow from positive terminal to positive to negative terminal of the battery. This is the direction, means suppose your battery is there like this. So this is a battery positive and negative. So here current will be flow always in this direction like this. Positive to, no, this is the current direction, will flow like this. So this is just basic definition or idea about electric current. Electric current is the rate of flow of charges. So I can be written as dq by dt. This is the basic formula for this. And if you want to draw some like a graph also, you can able to draw. If you draw the graph, how we can become the graph means, see here. See, if I draw IT curve means current time curve will be there taken. If I take one curve like this, so this is in terms of time, and here in terms of current, if you take like this. Now the area under this curve will give you the total charge. How you see, suppose example, if one curve rises like this and also stop like this, So what is the total charge flowing here? Time will be here to here, something like 5 seconds, and here like some 10 seconds, and here current to take some 5 ampere, like this. So then what happened? The area under this curve will give you the total charge flow. So here I just write down area under IT curve, area under IT curve will give the total charge flow, area under IT curve will give the total charge flow. Is it clear and able to see, you know? So calculate here what is the total charge flow over here, means here area, this is area triangle and area of rectangle will be there. So area is equal to area of, just like first year we did know, yeah, kinematics, same thing, area of triangle plus area of rectangle. So area of triangle formula will be half BH plus length into breadth. So half will be there, breadth will be 5, height also 5, plus length 5 into 5. So if I simplify this, then how much will come? 5 by 25 by 2, 37.5 coulombs. It's a simple example, 35.5 coulombs total charge flow in the given values. So like this we are able to, using the curve and in order to calculate. And suppose if they give any equations in a charge, then we can do integration, so we can get the differentiation. Suppose example, see, if charge is given as something, if Q is equals to AT square plus BT plus, see if they give like this one equation, so the differentiation of this equation, I will give you the total current at any point of the time. So what is the current will be there? Then then calculate current at t is equal to 3 seconds. Like this you can keep ABC are the constants, where ABC A comma B comma C are constants. Now you can find out also constant and also find out the dimensions of ABC. Dimension is not important, but in the question they are given, you are able to find out that also. First of all, find the current. So how to find the current means, so current can be defined as solution. So current I is equal to formula dq by dt, the rate of flow differentiation of the charge will give you the current. So charge equation is given, at square plus bt plus c. So that if you define, then I is equal to, we can write d by dt of at square plus bt plus c, like this. Do differentiation, a is constant, d by dt of dt square, d by dt r square plus b into dt by dt plus d by dt of c. So this is the way we are doing, already you know differentiation. So simply for this is a into 2t will come, plus this is 1b and plus 0. So the current equation will be 2at plus b. This is the current equation. So at 3 seconds they are asking, means you can able to calculate for 3 seconds. So at t is equal to 3 seconds, I is equal to 2a into 3 plus b. That means I is equal to 6a plus b, the current equation. So they give abc values, then you able to substitute. If they didn't give ab, then you can keep like this is the necessary answer we have to obtain for that. 6a plus b. Suppose if you want to find the dimensions, finding the dimensions is not difficult thing. Why? Because one side charge is given, this can be compared at square bt square. So that means this is necessarily, that means q is equal to what is given, at square plus bt plus c is given, right? So that means q must be equal to at square, or a is equal to q by t square will become. So q is equal to what is the dimensions, q will be a into t by t square. So then this will go up, a is equal to a t power minus 1 will be the dimensions of a. Or at the same time, if you want to find b also, you can find out q must be equal to bt. So b is equal to q by t, q is equal to a t by t, t t cancel, it must be a. And c also can be calculated, c is equal to q only, q is equal to a t only. These are the dimensions for abc of equation. In the given equation, this can be the necessary dimension formulas. But they didn't ask dimensions. If you ask, you can go ahead like this. So otherwise you can basic formula, they're given some equation, I is equal to if charge is given, at square plus bt plus c. See, in order, suppose they give current also, they if they ask you find out the charge in reverse, means you have to do integration for the process. But in this question, what they give means charge is given as at square plus bt plus c, then you have to find out the current at any time. Time is given 3 seconds or whatever the time period, you can substitute. So you have to take current formula. Current is equal, current I is equal to dq by dt. So dq by dt, this is the equations. If you do, then you simplify, you will get a t value, I in terms of some equation. So that equation to t, they are given t is equal to 3 seconds, you have to substitute. Then t plus substitute 6, they will get 6a plus b. This is the necessary equation for the given question. So like this, we can able to understand what is meaning of electric current. Electric current can be a rate of flow of charges. So this is the basic formula for electric current. Okay. So I'll discuss some other topic. Students, next topic we'll see, that is about current density. This is also one of the important topic. Already you know about density, right? So density is just nothing but mass density, you know. But here current density indicated with the letter J, it is a vector quantity. So this is a very important topic. Why? Because whenever this is a conductor, again you take through this conductor, through a cross sectional area, what is the rate of flow of charges will flow, that we call it as current. Now the current also, how much quantity, how much denser is flowing through a cross-sectional area, we call it as current density. Means you have to take some cross-sectional area in this way. So this is a cross-sectional area. So through this cross-sectional area, in the direction of current, current always we are taking a positive to negative direction only. So in the direction of current, what is the, this is the current direction. In this direction, how much amount of current to flow through this cross-sectional area. Suppose this cross-sectional area is A. So through this cross-sectional area, how much amount of current is passing, that ratio we call it as current density. So the definition of current density J is equals to, so current by area, so how much current is flowing and through how much cross sectional area. So we can write like this, current by area. This is basic definition for current density. So current density J is equals to current is I by A, we can write like this. And this is a J is a vector, current density is a vector, it is a vector, indicates in the direction of current flow. It is a vector in the direction of current flow. In the direction of current flow. So whenever, if this is a normal current direction is normal, then no issue. If it is not normal, we have to take it's a cross sectional area. Suppose this is a conductor. So in this conductor, this is a cross sectional area, and current direction is in this direction, and area normal direction also in this direction. So area vector we have to take here. So area vector already discussed in that previous class, what is meaning of area vector means the total area offered normally in the direction of current flow, that is called area vector. So what is the area offered here? So suppose if it is circular, then this option will be a 2 pi r. So we can write like this also, J bar can be written as in terms of vector I by A into area vector can be written as a cap unit direction in the direction of a vector. So that this is just a, you can write like area vector itself only, area make a cap by a will be area vector. So this you can keep like this. So suppose if it is in component direction, so component direction means component direction means the area is not like this. Suppose this is the conductor, but take cross sectional area like this, making an angle theta with the direction, means this is the conductor. So through the conductor I am not taking, in this direction current is flowing, so this is the current direction. So but the area was component to the current direction. So in that case what you will take means, in current direction what is the area offered. Suppose this is the normal direction, from normal direction if it is making angle theta, then this area will be, this is divided into two components, so this will be what will come, a cos theta, correct or not. So area offered will be here a cos theta, then your current current density J can be written as I by a cos theta can be written as, so a cos theta is the net area present in the direction of current flow. In current flow direction, the normally this much area, if theta is equal to 90 degrees, then if it is like this, then no area present in the current flow direction. So then we don't want to take, we can take like J is equal to I by a cos theta, we can take like this. So in case of constant current flow, or in case of constant, if it is not constant, you can take different form also. Then this can be taken as a like a dot product also, dot product in the sense, and this I can be defined as in terms of area vector. So this is multiplying, then we can write I is equal to J A cos theta, we can write I is equal to J A cos theta in terms of current density. So this is J A cos theta can be written as J, this is A bar, and this is also I also the vector. So I can write J bar dot A bar, then you can, this is the dot product. So I is equal to, we can write as J bar dot A bar also. This is the dot product of area vector and current density will give you the electric current at any place. So these are also formulas for this. I is equal to j cos theta, j is equal to I, or means current can be defined in terms of area vector. Area vector can be defined in terms of the current. If sometimes they give you variable current, this is about constant. Here j is constant current density, where j is constant current density. Suppose current density is not constant, it is a variable, means depending on the place and size, shape of the conductor, j is varying, it's not constant, then what you can go, means you have to go for integral calculus method. So up to here you understand, no? So once again I'm repeating here, current density, what is current density, means the total current flow through a cross sectional area. That means current density is a vector quantity. So current density can be defined as current to total current by total area in the current direction, or normal to the current direction, then that can be defined as current density. So current density J can be written as I by A, current by area. So in direction wise, if you take current, it is a vector quantity. It means it depends on the direction. If the direction changes, the area changes, and that the total current density in that particular place, in that particular point, it will be changes. So J can be I by A, we can write. So then component direction also, if you take A cos theta, or J can be defined as I by A cos theta. Current by A cos theta is the normal area present in that current direction. Suppose depending on the theta, theta is can be 90 degrees, then I by A will come. If theta is equal to 0 degrees, then total area will be I by A, and 90 degrees it will be 0, you have to consider depending on the direction theta. So actually this is not, this is the total area, and this is the area will become theta. If you take normal direction, this area will be taken as A cos theta, means normal to the direction. This is the direction of current in this direction, this is the normal, and this is the total area. Total area existed normal in this direction if you take theta over here. Suppose the theta, if you take with respect to with respect to horizontal, then this will become as area. So depending on the theta where you are taken, that is important. So however you take, the formula is will not change. So current density j bar can be written as I by A cos theta, depending on the theta, what the direction you are taking with respect to vertical or with respect to horizontal. But anyway, the meaning is this is a total current, and this is normal area offered in that particular current direction. Okay, that you can remember. And if you take this can, I can be j a cos theta, a b cos theta is equal to a bar dot b bar, like this. I is equal to j dot a, we can write. That means the dot product of area vector and current density will be common, will give you as total electric current in that particular conductor. So we can calculate like this. Dot, based on this, many questions can be created on dot product or angle or area will give or current will give, whatever the values will give, we can use these formulas, very useful. Okay, now I'm trying for calculus method, right? So calculus method, suppose if J is varying from one place to another place, so then what you will do, current due to variable current density, variable current density, then current density is not constant, then that time we know that as I is equal to j bar dot a bar, so this is the dot product, or this is equal to j a cos theta, we are writing, where j is constant. Suppose j is not constant, j is varying, then what will come means small current you have to take in that particular direction. That means suppose this is the conductor and this is the area, and area is constant, but current density is not constant through this area. Through this area, here more current density, less current density, depending on the some material, it will change the density. So that time what you will do mean, you have to take small area again. This is a small area you have to consider. This small area can be considered as something like DI. DI is the small area. Through that small area, small current density, current density will be J if you consider. Then how I can tell, so through small, this small area, through small area small current is flowing DI. So then that only I can write, if DI is the small current, okay, small current flow in small area, small area DA, small current flow in small area DA, then what I can write from this formula, what is this formula, I is equal to J bar DA, J we are treated as a constant, then DI I can write it as J bar dot DI DA bar. So this is a small current flow in small area. So in same direction if you take, then you can eliminate this dot product, or we can keep also, no issue, as per your situation requirement. Then DI is equal to J bar DA bar DA, and dot product will be cos theta will be considered like this. So this is the small amount of current in case of a variable cross section. So if you want total amount of current, then you have to do integration for this. So if I do integration, what I can get, total current I is equal to integral DI, we can write. So integral DI already is there. So total current I is equal to, you have to do integration. So integral DA cos theta, integral J bar DA bar cos theta, you can keep like this. Same thing I'm using, I'm not using any different thing. So suppose if you same direction, then theta is equal to 0, then automatically J dot DA will come. If you can write, if theta is equal to 0, means same direction, same direction, then what I can write here, I is equal to integral JDA, we can write. Here J is not constant, J is variable, that's why you should not take out of the integration. So this is the limits, I is equal to, in case of J, same direction. If direction also changes from point to point, then in other direction, we can write I is equal to integral JDA cos theta, or if you take cos theta inside also, you can write like this, integral J cos theta into DA also you can write. So however the situations, formulas, problems are given, or if you want you can write dot product also, or simply you can write I is equal to integral J dot J bar dot DA bar, we can write. So this is a better way we can represent, so that a current can be calculated by using variable cross section. This variable cross section concept only ask in your NET, JEE main and advanced level. For board level this much not required. What is meaning of current density and what is the formula for the current density, if you explain like that, that much is enough for that. But now current density is very important concept. Why? Because it is depend on the area vector. So area vector can be defined like this. Current density means area by current, and so total current by total area. So it is a vector quantity. We can write like area vector in terms of that. So A is the area vector. You can write area vector. So area vector concept already I was discussed. That's why I'm not giving that much stress on that. So we can finally formula can be obtained. J is equal to I by A cos theta or J A cos theta. You can calculate the current by using the dot product of area and this is directly you can obtain dot product when J constant are in same direction. Then you can use like this. In case of current density is varying, so they give some constant or some equations, then we have to go for calculus method. I will give you some numerical examples so that you're able to understand that this concept. So I'll take one example and come back. See students, I bought some question example. This will be best give some idea about variable current density. Normal constant current density in your board exams you will come, but this is competitive question. See, I'm reading the question. In a long wire of round cross section, able to see, no, long wire of round cross section of radius r, current density varies with the radial distance from axis of the wire is J is equal to C x square, where C is the constant. Ampere per meter square, this is ampere per meter square units of current density. Current can be measured in ampere and area will be measured in meter square. So ampere per meter square, and find the total current flowing in the wire where C is a positive constant. So what we have to find out means total current in the wire we have to calculate. So we can calculate first of all some diagram based understand. See, this is a long wire round cross section. So this is the wire is there. So through this wire axis, middle axis is this. So through middle axis, this is the radius of the wire from here to here. Now here through this area, if you take current density constant means whole area I can consider by the current flow in one direction, either upward or downward, however you take, no issue on that. But what happen means your current density also varying. So what I have to do means varying with the distance. So at a distance x you have to take some elemental strip, you have to take of length dx you can take. So some elemental strip, this is like small elemental strip we have to consider like this. This is the strip I have to consider inside. So at that width of the strip is dx and the radius length is x, understand? So like this all, if I do integration, then this is the x length at a radius x. I have to consider this strip, and through this strip the total current flow in the strip will be, suppose some amount of current flow through the strip will be, may say something di over here. So the di current flow in that small elemental strip you consider. So what is the current? You can write here current flow in elemental strip current flow in elemental strip di. Generally di what we can write means j dot j details. Here current direction and elemental area direction is same only, but if you want you can write like j bar dot da bar. I told you, no, so the area, now area we can be written as 2 pi r 2. This is the x radius, so width dx. So area of this elemental strip can be da. So then what I can write, same direction means as the direction same, di is equal be written as j da. So da I have to calculate. Da means what is da here, is equal to area of elemental strip. So area of elementary strip means length and cross length into width. Length will be 2 pi x, x radius I am taking the strip length, radius is 2 pi x, circumference is 2 pi x, radius x into width will be dx. So this is the dA. So then you can write dI is equals to j into 2 pi x dx. J already given in that equation, j is not constant, j is given as cx square, so I am using that. So dI can be written as cx square 2 pi x dx. So this is a necessary equation. You have to do, this is a small current flow in the direction of a strip through that. So whole current I want through the conductor due to this variable current density. So total current if you want, total current I is equal to integral, this is a common thing, integral dI, you have to do integration. So what can be the dI here, we see x square x cube is there. So integral c x square x, so that will be x cube and 2 pi dx, correct na? So all the constants you take it out, constant 2 pi c dx, constants 2 pi c. So integral dx x cube dx will come. So do integration for x cube, that will be 2 pi, 2 pi c. From where to where integration limits, from 0 to r, radius will be 0 to r of the conductor, radius of throughout the conductor, radius 0 to r you have to do substitute. So if I do integration, this will be x cube integration x to the power 4 by 4 under the limits, and 0 to r will come. So here 2 ones, 2 twos also can cancel. So then what will come here, 1 by 2 pi c r power 4, r power 4, this is r cube, r power 4 is the necessary answer. This is the total current obtained in the direction current density by using current density, variable current density. Variable current density, this is the necessary answer for that. So 2 pi c, c is a positive constant, we can't do anything, and r is the radius of the circumference. So current is there. Suppose if they ask is it in proportional square, means you can, in this case only I is proportional to r to the power 4. Why? Because half pi c, these are constants. It is very means according to the given situation. So I is proportional to fourth root of radius of the given conductor, and this is very good example asked in previous JE main exam some year I not remember, but it is a main exam. But this question is mainly based on variable current density. Current density is varying according to the given equation. Given equation J is equal to Cx square. So by using current density, you have to work out the definition. Simple, we have to consider conductor and some elemental strip we have to consider. Why elemental strip? Means through that elemental strip, current density taking constant, and it is varying throughout the conductor from radius, from 0 to r radius, the current density is varying. So for that purpose, I am taking current density, current formula J dot dA, or current in same direction can be taken like this. And area dA is area of the elemental strip, length into width, length is 2 pi x, circumference. So J is given, substituted, and do integration, and I got answer like this. So this is the way we can use current density concept in different ways. So not only this is a question I took based on variable cross section, but if it is in your NEET exams, they don't ask variable cross section directly, the relation between dot product, cross product, this kind of things also they will give you. J and A ask area or radius or some other parameters. While you're solving the objective questions, you will get all the use of this current density concept. So today for this concept, you practice what is a current and what is current density. And in next class, I will discuss drift velocity and all other topics. Thank you so much, all of you.